Hey, what's going on, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Making a Playlist with your boy Stony T. Now, on today's episode, we are kicking off our winter playlist, which is untitled at the moment. I challenge you all, you know, my subscribers, my followers, with the task of naming my next playlist, my winter playlist. So the winner will receive a $50 Cash App direct deposit into their Cash App account on Christmas Eve at 11:59 p.m. right before the clock strikes 12 midnight for Christmas Day. So I will be announcing that live on the Growth Spurts YouTube page. So it'll be my first time going live. But if you have not already and you are interested in entering the Growth Spurts first holiday cash giveaway, you can either look at the video that I posted before this, or you can look at the end of this video for the rules and the ways that you can be considered for that prize. So check that out. So on today's roster, we have some legendary stuff, okay? We're gonna kick it off with Mariah Carey's Oh Santa, that features Ariana Grande and Jennifer Hudson. Like, wow, 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 like bam, bam. I just feel like it was like heavy hitters, heavy hitters, you know? Kind of like this.
In the hymns, he's trying to get
night,
the
ring.
Oh, Mamma Mia, the problem child.
Is it too soon? Too soon? Okay, all right. And then we're going to talk a little bit about a new track from Lil Baby and a new artist that I'm really feeling, Fouché. So we'll get into all of that right after this. So I'm just gonna keep it honest with y'all. I be depriving myself from watching certain things. I'm like, I wanna do reactions. I wanna react to something, you know? So I have not watched Mariah Carey's Oh Santa video in its entirety. I have heard the song. So I'm gonna just keep it real with y'all. Christmas music is just not really my gig. Like I don't, and it may be I'm a little scarred, a little trauma, a little PTSD from when I worked at TJ Maxx back in the day. When I was in my bachelor's program, and it was Christmas time, and they kept playing the same Christmas music over and over. And it just kind of like tarnished the whole Christmas music thing for me. I don't get into it that much. But Mariah Carey, we know, is the queen of Christmas. And so when I saw these features, I was like, wow, wow, she's really coming with it. So we're gonna go ahead and get into it. As you already know, I'm gonna be watching it on my other phone, you know, and it'll be up here on the screen for us to kind of follow along. So this is my reaction to Oh Santa by Mariah Carey and Ariana Grande and Jennifer Hudson. I keep saying it and it still is not clicking for me. That is iconic. That, wow.
Come on,
Jen. Ari. So everybody looks good. Everybody looks really good. You know, I like the fact that they started off with the kid elves or whatever. I thought that was cute, them doing their little dance and everything. And so I'm guessing like Mariah Carey is like some type of magical genie. Maybe she's Santa. I don't know, but she made Jennifer Hudson appear and Ariana Grande. And if you can make them appear, that's some pretty dope magic. Come on, little hip swivel.
Come on,
So y'all know what I like about this. I like the fact that, you know, it's Mariah's song, and you can tell that it's Mariah's song. I mean, just by the placement of the ladies, you know, they're kind of in the back. Not saying that they're background, because these are no background singing ladies, you know. But, you know, we know that Mariah Carey is the queen of Christmas. So her bringing them along on this ride, on this ship, you know, I'm sure that they were very grateful for it, you know. This is a big collaboration, and the song, you know, is a little catchy. It reminds me of, oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Mickey, hey, Mickey, excuse me. That's what it reminds me of. But I also kind of feel like that this might be a remix of one of her old Christmas songs that was on her Christmas album. I'm not sure, so. Anyway, like I said, I'm not big on Christmas music like that, but this type of stuff, this could make me get into it. This is the type of stuff that makes me get into it. All right, let's keep going. Okay, so let's just talk about how J-Hood just ate that up, okay? We already know, like, I was waiting to see if she was going to bust through with some power notes, because she came off soft, you know, in the first verse. She came off kind of soft, and I like what she was giving, you know, let everybody shine. And that's what I like about it. It seems like everybody's getting their opportunity to shine on this song. And then also let's talk about the little choreography, little hip swivels and stuff. I see you, ladies, you know. Little choreography, you know, I like it. These elves are living their best life. Do you hear me? They are living their best life. Mariah, that little milk and cookies was a little suggestive now. The milk and cookies, y'all saw. That was very touch my body. That was very touch my body-esque. So y'all know that's going to live on in history. A double whistle note from them two, you know, wow. I'm really glad that they did this collaboration. And of course, J-Hood, we're not going to leave J-Hood out of it, because I saw a lot of buzz about Mariah and Ariana, you know, on the same track. But they were tending to leave Jen out. Like, you're not going to count Jen out like that. But that right there, you know, I know that people are going to be talking about that for a while.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. So I have not watched all of Mariah's Christmas, magical Christmas special yet, but I'm going to get into it. I know that from this video, I was very envious of the elves. Like, I would have been getting down like those elves was getting down in that video. I mean, they got them a piece in that video. I would have been happy too. I mean, that's big. A big collaboration like that. Everybody's voices blended well. It was just well done. Really well done. Very classy. I would like to see that one top the charts as well. You know, maybe she'll have a number one and number two spot this holiday season. Because we already know that All I Want for Christmas is right on its way up to top 10. It always is. So, wow, I loved it. So tell me how y'all felt about that in the comments section. I mean, am I overreacting? Like, what's, you know, but it, to me, that was iconic. That was legendary. All right, so moving right along. All right, now from the North Pole all the way to the dirty South, Atlanta, GA, we're gonna talk about Lil Baby. He's recently come out with two songs. I don't really know what the other one is because I wasn't too much feeling the other one. That's no shade to Lil Baby because he really comes through with the beats, you know, with the lyrics, with the subject matter. He really always comes through for me. So I'm just gonna play a little bit of Everybody. Cause that's what I'm on right now. I'm on that.
I'm flying at everybody. Helicopter in the middle of the hood, I'm flying everybody. I just fame these niggas be chasing, that's why I don't care about it. Boy, you play, you gon' die front of everybody. Leave some blood on the street by some red bottoms. Hard to hell, but I wish that they head shine up for my niggas know where the fuck got you for everyone around me. I ran it up, how the fuck did you die?
All right, that's enough. Y'all check out Everybody by Lil Baby. Everybody, that's Errbody. So y'all check that out. I know he's got a video out for it. I have not checked out the video, but if the video hot, I might react to that. But I love the song. I like the beat. I like the fact that he switches up flows throughout the song. It's like it just shows you what type of lyricist he is. He's not just a one note type of lyricist. Check out Lil Baby. And we just gonna keep this train moving right on along, because I'm not gonna hold y'all. I want y'all to be thinking creatively of those playlist names so you can enter to win this $50. So I'm just gonna tell y'all what's on the playlist. Moving right along. All right, so the next artist that we're gonna talk about is a fairly new artist. Some of y'all may remember her from, I think, season 15 or 16 of The Voice, when she was on Adam Levine's team. I don't keep up with The Voice faithfully like that, so I don't remember her, but her name is Fouché. You might remember her from a song called Deep End. That's what I remember her from. Let me play Deep End a little bit for you, so you can maybe get an idea of who I'm talking about.
I've been trying not to go off the deep end. I don't think you wanna give me done. I've been trying not to go off the deep end. I don't think you wanna give me done.
Okay, so I'm not gonna lie, you know, Lecrae, he's my artist. We talked about him the first episode of Making the Playlist, I believe. So his version of Deep End was what I know. But then I started hearing her version every time I went into the gym. Fouché's version every time I went into the gym. I was like, who is this artist? You know how you get protective over your artists and stuff? You're like, who is this that's, you know, messing up my boy's song like that? So this is the song that has made my playlist, and it's titled Single AF by Fouché. Love how I come in. I'm losing.
I'm testing my patience. Confronting my fears. And finally faced them. Now I can say I'm good on my own. I put in the way, making a change and comfortable. But it's definitely something I've done before. Finally ready to go out and get it. Never felt so sexy. Feel bad for my actions. I'm living my life. And I don't see
so before we go on, you know, I know y'all enjoying that. If y'all haven't heard this song, y'all gotta get into it. She reminded me of my girl Kirby a little bit when she went up like that. I was not expecting her to go up when she went into the hook like that. Love it. Love it. She has versatility. As you can see, she was doing a little rap singing in the verse, and it was like in the pocket. It was spot on. And then she has range. I'm going to have to go back and watch videos of her on The Voice, because I know she ate it up. She ate this track up. So we're going to keep on going, going to play it throughout the chorus and wrap this thing on up and let y'all get back to creating a playlist name. Because right now we do not have a name for this playlist. I'm going to keep saying it. We all got a name for this playlist. The competition is still open. Okay, I went a little bit further than the chorus, but see, y'all have to go check her out. She's probably got like two other songs on Apple Music that I haven't really checked out yet, but I do continuously listen to Deep End, and Single AF is on my winter playlist, which is still untitled. I'm gonna keep on pushing y'all until y'all get these entries in. I got a lot of stuff in the comments, a lot of entries in the comments, but make sure that you read the rules and send everything to the email address on file that I've asked you to send. So make sure you do that and stay tuned, because we're gonna at least have one or two more episodes of making a playlist, and maybe they can give you a better idea of what to name the playlist. You know, some people have to have the content first before they know what they can name it. And I get that, and I understand and respect that process. All right, everybody, so that is all for this episode of Making a Playlist. I hope everybody's having an amazing week, and I will see you next time. Take it easy.